Hey Capricorn, welcome to Queen Airbender Tarot. Today we're going to do your general love reading for mid-November. Keep in mind, these are general readings, which means they cannot possibly apply to every single person that's watching. But if you would like a personal reading, all the information will be in the description box below. In case you're new to the channel, welcome. Come on in. And in case you're returning, thank you for joining me again today. So for all of the new viewers, I'm an intuitive tarot card reader, which means I read the traditional sense of the card. But more than anything, I'm always going to give you guys some messages that I pick up intuitively. I charge both of my decks on top of crystal organite pucks. In doing so, it charges, balances, and aligns the energy for your reading. I also meditate over the collective energy. So again, this reading is for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals. And as always, I hope everyone's doing well. So when I was meditating over you guys' energy, the song that I heard was Bye Baby by Nas. I will leave the link to the song in the description box below so you can click it and listen to it following the reading if you so choose to. So I'm getting a lot of messages, a lot of legal stuff going on with you guys, okay? Someone could be trying to fight you for assets, or you could be trying to fight someone for assets. I feel like this is definitely dealing with some couples who are married. Also, someone who has financial stake with each other. Also, for individuals who have lived together and have property together, and you're trying to split assets down the middle, but somebody is not trying to play fair. Okay, I've just seen the Six of Pentacles in your pre-shuffle. Also, the Justice card. So, for some of you guys, it could be, I'm picking up a strong energy of a situation that is going to lead you guys to court. Also, Major Arcana, the Justice card, is the card of Libra, someone rising in Venus individuals. So, some of you guys could be dealing with someone who has that strong placement, or you could have that placement. Okay, so let's see what we get for you guys today. We're going to part the cards, change the card at the bottom. We'll do the same for your clarifying deck. And then we'll get into your reading. And as I just did that, the cards almost kind of jumbled. So I feel like for someone, things could be getting a little messy. At the bottom of the deck, yep. Somebody is dealing with some type of sorrow and sadness. And, you know, cups us emotions. Some of you guys could be dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus individual. But more than anything, I feel like somebody, there's a breakup. And I feel like it could be a little nasty. And someone is definitely in their feelings and heartbroken about the situation, most definitely. As we part the deck, yep. Ooh, a lot of you guys could definitely be dealing with water sign. Okay, you have Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. And I feel like this person, there's a separation, but I feel like someone is missing you, or you're missing, someone's missing you, or you're missing them. Okay. Keep in mind, the song that I heard, Bye Baby by Nas, this was this album that he did after his this was the song that he did after his divorce. And remember, I was just saying, with the Justice card, something is going to happen as far as the law having to step in, somebody, you know, some type of mediation, because things aren't going to go smoothly for some of you all. The next card I see sticking out, you could be at a physical or an emotional distance. And with this coming up right behind it, I feel like a lot of you all, you or this person is at an emotional distance from one another right now. And I feel like it could be you, because the next card is, Pentacles. You have the Nine of Pentacles, single woman, single man. You see how she's facing 1, 2, 3 Pentacles. So for some of you guys, this could have been a breakup, because a little birdie, she has a bird on top of her head. A little birdie told you something in regards, or you found out some information in regards to a third party. Wow. Okay, and for those of you who always say, why is there always talks about third party, right after I said that, she had Three Pentacles in front of her, okay, and now you have a Three of Cups. Yeah, there's some information about a third party. Also, with Three of Cups, are celebrations and coming together, reunions, but more than anything, I feel like if you guys were looking for some type of clarity and some type of answers in regards to a resolution as far as some type of, you know, something that you did with courts, I feel like it's going to go in your favor. The next card I see is the Hangman. And I feel like, okay, especially also if you, because you had a lot of water energy. If you're dealing with a water sign, ooh, yeah, this person's hurt. Yeah. And again, I'm going to say we had the Three energy and now you got the Three of Swords. Yeah, this person's hurt. You have Pisces with the Hangman. This person or you are unsure about what to do moving forward with the situation, okay? At the bottom, wow. At the bottom of the deck, you have the Eight of Swords. Feeling stuck, feeling like you can't move, feeling like you can't find your way out of a situation. But I don't feel like it's going to be long that that's going to be the case, okay? I feel like these gloomy days are getting ready to clear up for you all. As we part the deck, just as I say that, I feel like these gloomy days are going to clear up for you. Look at that. You have the Eight of Swords. Right after that, you have the Nine of Swords. Still been in your head, sleepless nights, feeling overwhelmed, anxiety. But it's getting ready to have some healing. Okay. Wow. Look at these next cards. Okay. So there's still going to be some healing. Okay. You have Major Arcana, Star card. That's wish fulfillment and healing. That's also an energy of Aquarius, because we do have a lot of swords here. You have the Eight of Swords, Nine of Swords, and then you have Aquarius, that's also air. Very next card, right? We have the Ten of Cups, happiness, wish fulfillment with someone that you are married to or engaged to. For some of you guys, there could be a working out and coming back together, some type of reconciliation. But for others, I feel like, you know, this is basically talking about the breakdown of, and resolution of a marriage. Next card we have right here, Queen of Wands. This person could be stubborn, have some secrets. I always say with this black cat right here that talks about mysteries, secrecy, things that are, you know, being concealed, because the cat is right in front of her, okay? And the next card that we see sticking out is the Three of Cups. I mean, I'm saying Three of Cups because I'm just being guided that you have one, two, three people right here, and there's a third person sneaking off right here. And this is the Six of Cups, okay? So I'm going to say this again. For a lot of you all, there was some type of third-party situation, for sure. And I'm saying Three of Cups because we literally had Three of Cups a few minutes ago. And then you have one, two, three people in this card, okay? And I feel like, again, I'm going to say this is someone that you already know, you have history with, 6+ years. You could have possibly separated from this person 6 days, 6 weeks, or 6 months ago. But I feel like for a lot of y'all, it's more so 6 weeks to 6 months is what I'm picking up. Let's power the deck so we can shuffle. And that one wanted to slide out again. Look at that. I'm going to shuffle it upright so you guys can see. Just seen the Emperor. So you guys can see that, yeah, these cards are being parted randomly. Look at that. Wow, so you got the Eight of Wands to the Seven of Wands. So Eight of Wands, fast-moving communication coming in, and then Seven of Wands, blockages. Some of you guys could definitely be dealing with a fire sign, Leo, Sag, Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and the visual. I feel like some of you all could be trying to communicate with this person, but this person is blocking you, or vice versa. Let's see who we get for you today, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Look, yeah, and I was going to keep shuffling, but look at that. Ten of Swords. And then the Page of Swords reverse. This person could be younger than you or just emotionally immature. But I'm also going to say this person feels like if you don't have strong air sign placements in your chart and you're dealing with the air sign, this person feels like you stabbed them in the back, in the front. You betrayed them. Yeah. And I feel like a lot of you are, you're blocking communication between this person. You're not communicating with this individual. Bottom of the deck, Seven of Wands in reverse. I feel like you guys are finally going to be able to communicate in a peaceful manner. But I don't feel like, for some of you guys, it may not still have some type of resolution here. Nine of Cups in reverse, yeah. It may not be a positive resolution for some of you all. Let's get your two cards, your general energy, and then your possible outcome, and then clarifiers for both for Capricorn. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and the visuals. Let's see what we get for you today. Okay. The Magician. Somebody's trying to manifest things to go in their favor. Major Arcana for Gemini, and also, again, more air sign energy, Gemini and Virgo, okay? The Magician, they are able to manifest and weave a web for things to go their way. And somebody's trying to manifest, because it's coming up, right? Someone's trying to manifest things to go their way, and also this could be a person who is manipulative. Bottom of the deck, yeah. Also, I feel like that some of them, they're trying to come back towards you. The World card talks about travel, distances. I'm also hearing that this person could be a different nationality than you. Someone could have also been manipulative and was lying and telling you that they were traveling, because it's about travel. Traveling for work, and you found out the truth. What is this? I see something sticking out back here. Yeah, Five of Wands in reverse. No longer wanting to fight. Somebody's like tired of fighting. Let's get a possible outcome for Capricorn. Okay. Somebody wants to. Wow, Major Arcana. What's up on here? Yeah, Nine of Wands. Nine of Wands, the wounded warrior. Tired of fighting. And someone just wants to move on and have a brand new start. Major Arcana for Aquarius again and Aries. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. So you have two Major Arcanas back to back. And you see how, yeah, okay. So you see how he's facing the Magician. Some of you all are just trying to manifest a brand new start. Let's see what's at the bottom of this deck. Yep, some of you guys are trying to, and this is you guys, Capricorn, Pentacles. Some of you guys found out about a third party situation, one, two, three Pentacles, and it interfered with your home life. And this is also like a card of divorce, depending on the cards that surround it. Like somebody wants to take the house, the kids, the dog. Okay, look at that. You got a dog right here in this picture. They want everything. Somebody's going for blood. But I feel like some of you guys are just ready to literally manifest a brand new start. The Fool card is taking a leap of faith into something new. Somebody wants a brand new start. Some of you all, you may have a love interest already. Because remember we kept saying cups his hand is clearly right here at the Cancer symbol. So some of you all can have a loon love interest who's a Cancer, and some of you all could be walking away from a Cancer. Let's hold the deck down to get an additional message. Some of y'all are, I'm going to say this again, some of you all may have already found a new love interest. You have the Page of Pentacles. You are Pentacles. You are Page. You are this Page for some of you all. Pages come in with messages of communication. And clearly, he's not accepting a Pentacle. He's ready to offer one. So for some of you all, you're interested in someone already. Look at that. Both of their hands, and this is completely different decks. Both of their hands are up in a certain kind of gesture, the same type of gesture. So I feel like some of you guys have already manifested a new start. And I feel like this is also pissing this person off, your love interest. I don't feel like they're going to be happy about that. Let's part the deck. Yep. Love is, and just as I said, some of you guys are manifesting somebody new. Again, here's more Gemini energy. Okay. So some of you guys could be manifesting a Gemini. Some of you guys could be manifesting a Cancer. Also, I'm picking up that some of you guys could have separated, because you see how there's a wedge and a divide in between them. Some of you guys could have separated during Gemini season, during May, also June. And some of you guys could also be dealing with a June Gemini. Yeah. I mean, June Cancer. Look at that. This person's watching you. This person's keeping tabs on you, especially if you're dealing with an air sign. And they're realizing that you are moving on. Look at that. Ten of Pentacles again. You got 1, 2, 3 people right here. Remember I said with the last Ten of Pentacles, if you go back in a video, house upside down, because a third party came in. 1, 2, 3 Pentacles right by this third person. A third party came in and turned your happy home life upside down. This could have been you. Could have been someone else, your partner. Bottom of the deck, yeah. Ten of Pentacles in reverse. Wow, I didn't even get to shuffle. Look at that. So you have the Magician, and then you have the Two of Pentacles. I'm going to say this again, okay? Some of you guys are definitely dealing with a Gemini. Even though this is Pentacles, you have Roman numeral 2, and it looks like the Gemini symbol. So some of you guys were juggling a water sign. You have the water in the background with a Gemini. Or just overall, if it wasn't you, this could have happened to you. Because you also have right here, this is a Gemini symbol. It's Roman numeral 2, but it looks like the Gemini symbol. And then you have Major Arcana, the Magician, Gemini. Also Virgo. And this is Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So some of you all are juggling with a water sign, an air sign, and an earth sign like yourself. But I also feel like some of you guys manifested something new, possibly with a water sign or a Gemini. Let's get a clarifier for the Fool card. Okay. Let's see. You guys see what we have right here? Yep. Okay. You have the Queen of Swords in reverse. I'm going to say again. Yeah. So I'm going to say again, for some of you guys, you're walking away from an air sign. Because we have both energies. You have an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, who could be nasty, cutting. Because the Queen of Swords is someone who is shady. I always say kings and queens in reverse are nasty. Sword down for me is no, sword up is yes. Swords is communication, also the mental. So the communication between you and this person could be quite nasty. Okay. For your possible outcome, you have a Fool card. Right? Taking a leap of faith into something new. And then you have the Queen of Swords. I'm going to say this again. You see how this queen is looking in the direction of the Fool card? This person sees you. Because remember, we had the Page of Swords. This person sees you moving on. And they don't like it. And I feel like they're going to speak on it. Also, I'm hearing for some of you guys, especially if you're going to court. Yeah. Especially if you're going to court and it's involving the air sign. You see how she's looking towards this Two of Pentacles? This person is going to try to fight you for everything. They're going to try to take your money, some type of assets. Because even look at his expression. It's almost like he's caught off guard. You see his facial expression? It looks like this person is going to try to, I feel like it's going to catch you off guard. How ruthless, because I'm hearing ruthless, how ruthless this person is going to come towards you. This person's coming towards you ruthlessly. Because, and it's really pissing them off that you have started manifesting something new. They may be seeing something on social media, because we did have a Page of Swords with the earlier pre-shuffle. So they could be watching you and seeing you on social media. They could be looking in your comments. Even if you don't, if you say like, oh, they don't follow me on social media, you don't know they follow you on social media. They have some type of fake account. They could also have a mutual friend watching you guys' account, so be mindful about that. Also, if you have mutual friends with this person, family members that you have not unfollowed or blocked, There's definitely an energy of lurking. I can tell you that for sure. There's an energy of lurking for sure. Okay. So Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals, as always, I'm going to ask that you continue to like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, take care. Bye.